Hey, it's Jeff, and this is Day 8 on the Viking expedition ship Octantis on the Antarctic Explorer Cruise. Today we woke up in Paradise Bay, where we plan to visit Base Brown. In last night's daily briefing, they talked to us about Base Brown, which is an Argentinian scientific research base. Now, it'd normally be staffed by scientists in the summer, but it wasn't being staffed this season. I think that was due to COVID. So none of the facilities were actually open while we were there. Options today include landings at the Base Brown by rib boat, as well as kayaking and special operations boat options. So we got off to an early start on a rib boat headed to the landing. On our way over, we stopped to watch a seal relaxing on some floating ice. And we also saw a group of penguins making their way across the bay. Eventually, we approach Base Brown, which is a handful of buildings on shore, and behind that, you see a 276-foot peak that you can actually hike up to the top of for some pretty amazing views. For the landing at Base Brown, the rib boats pull right up to the rocky shore, and you step out, so no need to get wet. However, the rocks can be pretty slippery here, so be careful getting out, and obviously the Viking staff are always there to help you out. Then you climb up a wooden staircase to the area of the base where the buildings are, which, as I mentioned, were closed during our visit. And just behind those buildings is a penguin nesting area, so you'll get to see those guys and also smell those guys as you get up to the top of the stair landing. From there, if you're up for it, you really should climb up to the top of the lookout. It starts off not too bad, but it does get steeper the higher up you go. They have hiking sticks available down at the bottom, but we got there before they had showed up, or some of them hadn't showed up, so we decided to go without, and my wife reminds me that we ended up sitting on our butts a couple of times on the way back down because of the steepness and the slipperiness of the snow. I must have blocked that whole part out because I don't remember. The route is well marked with poles, and there's also Viking guides in yellow jackets along the path to help you out if you need it. Now, as you get closer to the top, it starts getting pretty steep, and it actually gets steep enough that the path turns into switchbacks for that final push to the top, and this is where it gets a little harder. But the view from up there is definitely worth the hike. This is the spot you're hiking to on the island, so as you can see, you're pretty far up there, but amazing views. From there, you can see the kayaks down in the bay below. You can also see here a special operations boat tooling around out in the bay, and the Viking Octantis. We even had a bird hanging out up there with us for a while. When we got back down, we hung out for a bit watching the penguins. Now, these are Gentoo penguins, and they're a pretty curious group of guys, so this one came over to see what we were up to as he headed down the slope. Then we loaded back onto a rib boat and headed back to the ship. On the way, we got a good look back at the view of where we had just hiked to. It's pretty impressive. I also wanted to show you this. This is a good view of the difference between the regular outfits that you wear for shore visits, rib boats, and special op boats rides, compared to those for the kayak trips. The kayak outfits are much more watertight and they're sealed up. Now, the rest of that day was pretty typical for us. There was food, spa visit, exploring the ship, maybe a little dessert later on. And then that evening, as we headed out, we got to see some more of the whales just off the ship. That was neat. And next, we're headed to Enterprise Island for day 9. We'll cover that on the next video. Thanks so much to everyone who's watching the series. We'll talk to you soon.